if you find a USB cable in an airport, it could be the cable itself that hacks you. And think about this. The persistence is in the wire. You eradicate the malware from your system. The next time you go to charge your phone or sync your phone, it reinfects it. And this opens up a much bigger can of worms here, because this could scale up to entire supply chain attacks. You need to think about your supply chain. Now, given all that's happening in the world these days, organizations are very rapidly changing their supply chain tactics, right? It's happening right now. Many of your organizations are doing that in light of the medical conditions and such that are happening. You need to do that from a security perspective and with a security mindset, not just knee-jerk changing your supply chain to something that might even be more vulnerable. I urge you to read this wonderful document from the UK's National Cybersecurity Center.
We have changed culture in, you know, the past 18 to 24 months, where security has become foundational, right? You either build it on a secure environment, as secure as you can at the time, because cost, schedule, performance do not matter in an unsecured environment. It doesn't matter if you deliver something in the supply chain at the approved cost or at the performance that you agreed upon or the schedule, if you get it and it don't work.
Is this trade or is this national security? And the unfortunate answer is it's both. And it depends on who you're talking to as to which one they're going to prioritize. And part of the reason that we are in this situation with China and 5G is that for so many companies over the past 20 years, their answer has been, I'm going to prioritize the economic aspect and not the security aspect. Right. And so if we really are, you know, screwed when it comes to 5G and we want to think about securing 6G, then we need to spend an awful lot of time about thinking, how did we end up in the spot where we are now?
And the thing that I worry the most about is source code manipulation. We have seen some supply chain attacks, most famously with the Juniper code that was backdoored, and a number of security vendors have experienced the same thing. I'm surprised we have not seen more of these, and it's quite possible that they have occurred and we just haven't caught them. When you have an insider, particularly in your organization, not in an external threat actor, that is putting backdoors in your code, that is authorized to do so, really, really hard to catch in modern massive source code systems. Obviously, you also have added risks to open source packages and the like gets added to this.
To the extent that the US government can help create greater competition among equipment providers, the world will be better off. But we've got to have experts who can come up with some ideas, such as if the US needs its own telecom equipment provider, why in the world wouldn't the US call Huawei's bluff for the offer to license our 5G technology? Why wouldn't you at least have those conversations? And why don't you think about ways that the experts could say, you guys want to come into Huawei's facilities and Ericsson to deep dive. What can be done? How can third parties monitor what's happening in the actual creation and manufacture to make sure that we know what we're doing and there's independent transparency? Make requests to the companies of what can be done to add the kind of level of trust that's not there now. But to simply stand silent and not make demands and requests on the equipment providers doesn't help the situation.
We should have the discussion about what does supply chain risk look like? What does risk mitigation look like? Understanding that risk does not commute what my risk is, it's not what your risk is, it's a different paradigm, that we can have 100% have that 100% conversation, because it is absolutely needs to be.
Supply chain security is an insurmountably hard problem. It is not just the country, it is the equipment, it is the program, it is the assembly, it is the shipping, it is the update, right? We have fake apps in the Google Play Store. We had a Cisco box sent for the Syrian telephone company, the NSA intercepted. NotPetya is being distributed through a fake update to a popular Ukrainian accounting package. We can go on and on and on. And you can build a US-only iPhone, it'll cost 10 times as much, nobody will buy it. Our industry is deeply and irrevocably international in ways that make this impossible to solve. Now, that's not fun, but that's the world we're in. So now, what can we do given that?